Week 13, traders. Let's get something straight. If you're still worried, you're behind the curve. I know AG is off the lows. We have bounced. We're looking now for our sixth hit on the upper resistance trend line. Things are looking great. I'm encouraged. I know I'm the ringleader of this, and you guys are about to witness why I've been doing this. We now have support on the daily, on the 20 EMA. Volume is going to start picking back up again. Oil's flat out about to make new highs and enter a rally. Things could not be better right now. And everything that I am witnessing is exactly what I've been expecting. AG's next target is the 200 EMA. Now that I think we found support on the 20 EMA. That's near 687. We want to get on top of that, and once we do, we have then broke out of the one-year consolidation period, the pattern that everyone's been concentrated on, and you got to look forward now. We're looking to bigger and better things, because once we're above that 200 EMA, there's no more resistance. And what are the bulls going to do? They're going to take this bitch higher. There's no doubt about it. They're going to go to the monthly chart. They're going to look at the upper resistance, which is around $15. And that's where they're going to keep buying too. Why? To make a shitload of money and keep their jobs. No one was going to tell us this. Let's take a look. AG's monthly chart. The entire time, for the past 15 months, I've been telling you guys we buy on a lower support trend line, and I don't have that drawn in here. But it is there, and we buy on a lower support trend line while stochastics are oversold, so this way it increases our odds to make a winning trade. That's exactly where we are. You can see all of 2017 was near it. 2018 is definitely in it. Very difficult for me to make those choices back then when I'm trying to look at the US dollar, the silver futures, AG. But I did not know, and I was just telling someone this, I did not know AG was going to enter a consolidation period. The reason I did not know that is because I cannot tell the future. But as time has gone on, I know what pattern it is, and I know the meaning of that pattern. It may look like a sell-off to you guys. It's a bullish pattern to me. To me, it's telling me, buy. This is the time to step in, take your risk. Now you can see that we're oversold. And here in March, March is now higher than February. March closed higher than February, which is a great sign for us, for the bulls. And if we take a look at Bitcoin, I believe most of you guys bought while the stock was overbought. And for the past couple months, it's an example of what happens when you buy a stock that is overbought. You're putting yourself at much more risk. These indicators are there for a reason. It's what the professionals use to help protect themselves. And I'm going to say that again. Help to protect themselves. There are no guarantees. There are zero. And it's been a while since I've said that. I'm very confident. I feel I know the direction of this stock, but there are no guarantees. Although, I am extremely happy March closed higher than February, and I believe the rally has begun. So let's take a look at the daily. When I look at AG's daily chart, I see so many bullish signs, so many signs of encouragement. And you may be sitting there going, Joe, well, if you get rid of all the bullshit you put on there, all I've watched was the price keep dropping over the past 15 months. And I guess that's true. It's true. I got to admit it. But I also see the price range being squeezed tighter and tighter and tighter. And I've learned along the way of what that means. It means the bulls and the bears are in a fight right now. And from what I've learned, I believe the bulls are going to win. And in July of 2016, I see a whole lot of gaps around the $15 marker, which in the monthly chart was also the upper resistance area. Kind of a little coincidental, eh? These aren't coincidences. These are all indications, signs that people use to give them the edge to try and make a winning trade instead of a losing trade. I've got the two arrows there on the 18-year trend line, the support. We bounced off that in February. Now March is higher than February's lows. Isn't that the direct? I know it's scary, I understand, but that's a tiny little itty-bitty area. Ignore it. Look at the big picture. These patterns mean something. They have meaning. They're trying to give you an indication of the possibilities of what's going to happen in the future. I believe that to be fact. No guarantees, but we're off the lows, baby. Looks to me like we broke through a resistance trend line. Give this a little bit of time. I have a strong feeling we're going to be extremely happy this week. Things are looking great. And I got a feeling those stochastics are going to turn back up into the overbought area. Bounced off the 20 EMA. 200 EMA, around 687s, are our next target. It's going to be a good week. Silver futures monthly chart. Most important thing, look what happened at the end, or yeah, I guess it's the end of 2005. Nice huge rally. Why? Because that lower support trend line was stronger than the upper resistance trend line. Now in 2018, what do you think the scenario is going to be? I'll give you a hint. The scenario is now better to our favor that we are looking at another bull run, simply because that lower support trend line now has more strength with the years that have been added to it. That is an 18-year support trend line. The upper resistance was from the middle of 2016. Logically speaking, which do you think stronger? I'm sure you can figure this one out on your own. Silver futures daily, gap at $25. Thankfully, above us. Gives those bulls a nice little target. What do we got? We got more than six hits on that pennant formation. Maybe it's a bull flag. Either way, I'm happy with it. It's bullish to me. That's from 2016. Think it's coincidence. Just keeps going back, and that price range just gets tighter and tighter and tighter. Bulls and the bears are about to clash. Who do you think's going to win? I don't know. I mean, do the sellers have a large possibility of making more money? It doesn't look like it to me. It looks like they pushed their luck as far as they're going to go. I thank God I'm a bull. I'm going to stay a bull. Why fight the market? Markets are, they're inherently bullish. They just want to go up over time. Why fight it? Stay a bull. Looks to me like the bulls got a lot of room to run. They use the most recent highs as their next targets. I'm going to stay exactly where I am. This looks great. It's the same damn patterns over and over again. I don't care about the ticker symbols. This looks great. Let's see number... let's see this breakout. Things look great. DO's daily chart. Maybe we possibly have another pattern, an upward channel. Maybe that upper resistance line isn't really there. Although I know I have overbought areas along the top, there's only two, so it's not confirmed. No guarantees. I have three on the bottom. I'm ready to confirm it. I can see that Friday the bulls started stepping back in. Stochastics are not in the oversold area, but they didn't give a shit. I don't know. Looks to me like we got something bullish right here. What do you think the next move's going to be? If you don't believe anything that I've been telling you over the past 15 months, this may be the time for you to start believing. Could bring you a lot of money. I don't know, unless you just want to give yourself a 50-50 chance. I say there's a possibility this might give you I'll be conservative, a 1% chance better for the Bulls. So maybe now it's 51-49. Right, go hit the casino. They're not going to give you that good of odds. I like this. This could be the new DO pattern. Only time will tell. I'm going to put my money that DO is going higher. And there's another reason. Crude oil futures. Let's take a look. Crude oil futures monthly since 2007. Got our highs and lows all in one chart. You can see when crude oil was oversold in 2015, bulls have started stepping in. We are now above the 200 EMA, the most important resistance area, or what was resistance on the most important chart. Stochastics are in the overbought area. Doesn't mean they're done buying, just means that's where it is in this moment of time. And there's a possibility stochastics might become embedded in the overbought area, and we learned last week what that means. And if that happens, I'm willing to bet 86.97 is going to be the next target for the bulls. That's what I'm spreading. Crude oil futures since 2015. Stochastics in the overbought area. They could turn back up. There's no rule that says they have to go back down to the oversold. Sure looks like there's a bounce off the 20 EMA again. And we're fighting against the most recent highs in February. What do the bulls like to do? They like to make the most recent highs their target, and then they want to take the stock or the futures higher. Just like rocking down to Electric Avenue, and then we'll take it higher. That's what the bulls are. That's why I'm a bull. Now everything makes sense. Look at guys, we just bounced off the 20 EMA Thursday, Friday. We've got that upper blue resistance trend line for months now. I've been telling you, I think I'm going to get rid of that because we're going to go to that the target up above. I got a feeling stochastics are going to stay in the overbought area, which means they're embedded and there's nothing but buying and buying and buying, 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 buying. They're buying. This is the moment in time, and I got a feeling in due time, I'm going to be 2 for 2. Silver and oil. Oh, this is all coming together. It's taken a while. It's coming together. Monthly chart on US dollar. I'm looking at that black resistance trend line, that 1 year black resistance trend line from number 5 to number 6 and to where we are right now. I see the past 3 months. We lost support on the 200 EMA, then markets started playing games with us, we got back above it, and now March closed right above the 200 EMA. Does that mean it found support? Hell no. Let's see what's going to happen next month. I'm looking at the stochastics. They are officially embedded in the oversold area, and we've learned over the past few weeks what that means. That means they are selling, and they are selling, and they're selling. They've been selling for a year. If you're going to be the one who's going to pick the bottom and say, oh, well, this is where it bounces then. This is where the U.S. dollar is going to go up. I've got a year of information showing me the sellers are in charge right now. Don't guess bottoms. Don't guess tops. Keep your eyes open, look for the clues, look for the trends. The trend is down. I'm going to take that, I'm going to use it to my benefit. I'm going to say the US dollar is going to continue to sell off. And where to? We've talked about that. They're selling the US dollar. And from the very beginning, I'm making the bet that the silver prices are going to go up because the US dollar is going to fall. I've got 45 years of proof. I'm going to put it at the end just to remind you once again. Have confidence. I think we're about to see some big moves this week. And I do believe I am right that AG started the rally in March. The March candlestick is now higher than February's. Things are looking great. If you believe the logic, you do, because the only reason you're still watching these damn videos is because something makes sense. You're not able to put it all together. I understand. It's taken me 10 years. I wouldn't expect it out of you. And I know this is scary. It's difficult. It's tough. You're like, man, I've never heard this BS before. Why haven't I ever heard this? Because if they gave it all to us, we'd all screw the markets up. Imagine everyone stepping in at one time to send a stock in one direction. Gosh, man, we'd be chaos. So what do? They keep us in the dark. We're always trying to guess. And then there's, guys, everything's headed in the right direction. And let's take a look at 45 years of proof just to keep you calm. It's going to be a good week. And here you go, just as a reminder. Here's 45 years of proof. And the reason I decided to make these videos and try to help as many people as I could. This isn't like I just went off the deep end and said, oh my gosh, I think I know it. I've got 45 years of proof here. Why wouldn't it happen again? It doesn't make any sense to me. How are Goldman Sachs and all these companies making millions every single year? I've had probability and statistics in college, and I can't come up with a formula right now. That shit's long gone. But I know this isn't an accident. And I know damn well that once people find something good that's making them rich, a lot of them are going to just hog it and never tell a damn person, especially when it's illegal and they're going to lose their jobs. And they can't find another job out on those trading floors that are going to make them as much money. And sure, they deal with a lot of stress, you know, blah, 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 like all of us don't. This is all the proof I needed to make the decisions that I've made. And with this, I believe I'm making the right decision. I believe I'm helping. I believe this is going to turn out the way I want it to. I don't doubt any of this. And I believe this is going to be a very, very good week for us in April. Here comes the sun.
Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. I say, it's all right.